Hello guys, welcome to another interesting problem in the series of coding. Today we are going to do the problem. So at an array of zeros, ones and twos, we are given an array of size n having only zeros, ones and twos. You have to sort the array in ascending order. But the important part of this problem is you have to do it in O of n time complexity, and you don't have to use any extra space. Even the function is void, means you can't, put it in another array and return another array. You have to just sort it in place because you can't use any extra space. So how do we do this problem? Okay, let's take an example to understand this problem. Let's say this is our array. Now what are we supposed to do? We are supposed to sort the 0, 1 and 2 so that 0 always comes before 1, 1 always comes before 2. So basically if you observe, you have three clubs, right? You have a club of 0, club of 1, club of 2. All the zeros have to be grouped together first, then all the ones, and then all the twos. So you can divide the array into three clubs, right? While sorting, at any time, at any particular instance, the sequence that you should have is you should have some zeros clubbed together, and then you should have some ones clubbed together, some twos clubbed together, and remaining you will have unknown elements. Now what do you do of these elements, right? So these elements you have to distribute them in their own brackets. If you are able to distribute them in the respective brackets of 0, 1 and 2, your work is done. You will be able to sort the elements in the order of 0, 1 and 2, right? So while doing the sorting operation, just to simplify the problem, consider it like just dividing it into three brackets of zeros, ones and twos. Okay, now this is the approach, but how do we actually solve this problem? So we are going to use a three pointer approach. And what do these three pointer represent? See, let's have three pointers: low, mid and high. Now low will always be at that position, okay, before which all zeros are there. What about mid? Mid will be at that position before which all ones are there. All the ones are grouped together. And there will be a high pointer which will point at a position after which all twos are grouped together. And then there will be some unknown elements in between which you have to distribute them into respective brackets. Okay. So this is what is going to be our approach, and it will simplify the problem. Okay. Let's see. Let's say we are at this particular instance during the sorting. So let's start from here. Now what will happen in this particular case? See, so what are you supposed to do? You are supposed to put the elements from the unknown bracket to the respective positions, to the respective brackets. How do you do that? Okay, let's consider the first element. So let me erase this and let us take another color. Let's say we take blue color. Now this element you are supposed to group. Which bracket will it go to? It should go to the position before low, right? Before low it should go. So what we do, we will switch its position with this particular element. So we are switching these two. So 0 will come here and 1 will go here. Okay, now what? Now we have pushed the 0 to its position. Now what should we do? We should move the low and mid positions. Okay, so now our low and mid positions both will get moved by one place. Okay, so let us do that. So I shift my low position here and I shift my mid position here. Okay, now the unknown elements bracket has reduced. It is shrunken. That is what is our objective. Now you can observe again. Let me erase this blue, not to confuse. You can observe again, we have three brackets. Before the low, you have all the zeros. Okay, before the mid, you have all the ones. Between mid to high, you have unknown elements that you want to distribute. After high, you have all the elements which are two. Okay, now again, what should you do? You have to shrink this particular bracket. Okay, so how will you do that? Take this element. Where should it go? Where should two go? Two should go after high, right? So what will you do? I mean, you will switch these two elements. So let me do that. Let me switch 0 and 2. So 2 will come here, 0 will go here. Once you have done this, what should you do? You will shift your high. Okay, so let me erase this and let us shift our high. Okay, so we have shifted our high. Now again, we have reduced our unknown elements bracket. Okay, we have only two elements here. So first element is 0. Where should 0 go? 0 should go here, right? it should get pushed to the left. So that's what we are doing. So we will push 0 to the left and we will bring 1 here. We are just switching the elements. Okay. Once you do this, what should you do? You should move your low and mid. So that is it. So let me move low and mid. So low will shift by one position. Mid will also shift by one position. Okay. Now what our bracket has again reduced. So let me erase all this. And you can see that before low, you have this bracket. Between low and mid, you have this particular bracket. And between mid after high, you have this particular bracket. Now what you are going to do, if your current mid position is 1, you will just move the mid. Okay, you will just move the mid simply, so because we don't want to make any change right at that particular position, so our mid will reach here. Now what will you do? You will simply exit, because you see everything is sorted. You have the group of 1s, you have a group of 0s, 1s and 2s, right? So you have all the groups respectively. This is how we are going to do the sorting algorithm. And I started from between, but what we'll do is we will start from the beginning. We'll keep on moving the low and mid pointers, okay, initially until we reach our goal. So let's code that and then we will understand it better. Okay. So what we are going to do is we will start our low also from 0 and we will start our mid also from 0 and we will have a high pointer that will basically start from the end. So n is the size that is given, so n minus 1. Now what are we going to do? We are going to group them into the respective brackets. So while mid is less than equal to high, because we just saw when the mid exceeds high, everything is sorted. So what you're going to do is you're going to check the position at array of mid. Okay. If this particular position is, let us say, if it is 0, if the element is 0, then you have to switch it. Switch it with what? You have to switch it with the low position. Okay, so how do we switch? Switching is very easy. So you take a temporary variable and let's say you are declaring it as low, and then a of low is equal to a of mid, and then a of mid is equal to temp, right? This is just switching at positions low and mid. So that's it. Now after this, what you are going to do? After this, you are going to I think this is much more clearer. So after this, you are going to increment your low as well as increment your mid. Okay, because you have done the switching, you can move to the next elements. You have shrunken the unknown elements bracket. After this, what you will do? You will give an else condition. Else if a of mid, let's say it's equal to 2. Then what you will do? Do the same switching, but instead of this, you will switch it with high, right? So let us do that. A of high. And instead of low, I'm just giving high. And now what will you do? You have to decrement high. That's it. Else what you will do? Else means a of mid will be 1. Okay. Then you will just increment your mid. Okay. So that's it. I hope that this should work. Let me just run and see if it is working. Yes, it is successful. And it is actually not successful. Okay, see why it's not successful. I have given this here. I should have given a of mid. I have forgotten a bracket there. That's why the output was not right. Okay, it should be right now. Okay, this bracket should not be there. So we should take care of all these small things. Yes, it is fine. Let's submit and see if it is going to work. So it is queued right now and yes, it is working. Let me just close this. Thank you so much for being patient and listening.